Hi everyone, Carolina here from Creations-Handmade. Welcome to my channel. Today we're going to learn how to make glitter foam. This foam will remain flexible, it won't crack, and the glitter won't shed or rub off. And this is perfect to make projects like the paperclip ball, and I'm going to show you later on the video how to make this ball, so keep watching. We're going to need glitter. You can use any grid you like. I'm using ultra fine glitter. We're going to need foam sheets, and we're also going to need a brush. We're going to be using a little container, and I'm going to be using white glue that dries clear. This glue is the really inexpensive one that you can find at the Dollar Tree. This glue is really thick, which is perfect for what we're doing. Since the foam sheet is really porous, the thicker the glue, the better, because it won't absorb into the foam too quick and it will hold the glitter better. So I'm going to spread the glue. Notice I'm not brushing into the foam. I'm not pushing the glue into the foam. I'm just spreading it around so I can get an even coat. This way, the glue will remain on top of the foam a little longer, and that would be better because we will get a better finish with our glitter. We need to use a generous amount of glue, but make sure that you don't apply too much glue, because then what's going to happen is that you're going to create an independent film. The glue is going to dry on top of the foam, it's not going to dry into the foam, so it's going to peel off, and you don't want that to happen. You can see on the screen, I have a generous amount of glue and it's spread evenly. So now we're going to apply our glitter. So pick up the glitter you want to use and spread it all over your foam sheet. You're going to see, since we're applying a thick coat, we're only going to need one coat of glitter. Unless it happens like it did to me on this one, part of the glue dried up, so I'm going to have to fix that little bit. But you can see it's perfect. It's even and it looks gorgeous. Now I'm going to do the same because I'm going to use gold glitter. So I'm going to apply the glue to the other side of my foam sheet. Now I'm applying the glitter and you'll see here none of the glue dried, so the coverage was perfect. Even and beautiful. Now we're going to let it sit for around 45 minutes to dry before we apply the sealing coat. And here I used black foam and black glitter and it looks gorgeous. Our next step is to seal our glitter. Since my glue is thick, I'm going to mix equal parts of water with equal parts of glue to make it a little thinner. If your glue is not too thick, don't mix it with water because you don't want it too runny. So I'm going to mix it well. And then I'm going to apply it to my foam piece. Notice here how I'm not brushing. I'm not pushing the brush into the piece. I'm just sliding it so I can spread the glue around. This way I won't move any glitter that was loose and I will have perfect even coverage. So once our pieces are covered, they should look like this. We'll let it sit to dry, and when they're dry, they're going to look like this one. You can see the left side, the hot pink one, the fuchsia, it's already dried. So it's not rough enough and it's perfectly even. Doesn't it look gorgeous? Yay, we did it. So now I'm going to show you how to make the ball that you can use on your paper clips or to decorate presents or any projects that you want. So we're going to need a square piece. I'm going to use a piece that measures around 2.5 by 2.5 inches. I'm not measuring here, but you can do it if you like it better. Once I have the square shape, I'm going to make a cut around 1 1/8 inches. And I'm going to cut around 1 inch deep, as you see there. Then I'm going to leave around 3/8 inches and I'm going to make another cut up to 1 inch, as you saw how I did it there. That's going to give us a tail. And now I'm going to make it cut diagonally to meet the end of the cut that I made before. Just do it as I did here on the screen. We'll do the same on the other side, cut diagonally up to the cut that you made priorly there, and we're going to be left with a tail like this. turn it to the other side, and we're going to cut again diagonally up to almost half an inch. Then cut the other side again diagonally up to like half an inch. And we're going to remove that little piece in there. And what we're going to be left is with our bow shape. So cut it like this. And once we have it cut, this is the shape we're going to have. I didn't cut very clean there on one side, but I'm going to correct that later on. So we're going to use our hot glue and we're going to apply it in the center of the piece. Then you're going to get all the little ends and meet them together at the center. So they're all going to be glued in the middle and it's going to look beautiful like this. Now I'm going to correct the cut that I did before that was not too clean. And then you'll see how I get a flat top. Now what we're going to do is we're going to apply a little glue in the middle again. And then we're going to run our little tail. And our ball is starting to take shape. You have to round the tail to the other side when we glue our paper clip. But I'm going to show you, you don't need to use a paper clip. You can use this to decorate any project, just like this. And it will look so pretty. But now I'm going to show you, we're going to use a paper clip and we're going to glue on the side that has the open prongs. Make sure you do it on that side or you won't be able to use your paper clip. We're going to add a dollop of hot glue and we're going to stick our paper clip. Then we're going to run our little tail right in the middle in the center of the paper clip and run it through to glue it to the other side. Make sure it's adhered, and then this is what we're going to be left with. It's already beautiful this way. You don't have to add tails to it if you don't want to. I'm going to show you the one with the tails so you can compare the two. You can use it either way. They're both beautiful. But if you want to add tails to it, I'm going to show you what you need to do. You need to cut two little pieces and measure an inch and an eighth by half an inch. Then you're going to make it cut diagonally on one side. You're going to add glue to both sides. And then you're going to tuck the little tail in between the back of the ball and the paper clip, as you see me doing right here. You can make this ball bigger or smaller by using bigger or smaller squares. And we have a beautiful paperclip ball. You can use this for hair clips, to decorate mini albums, loaded pockets, planners, anything you have in mind. For gifts, presents, they're beautiful. I hope you like my video. If you did, don't forget, click the like button, subscribe, and I'll see you back here soon for another video. Bye-bye. Love you guys.